does CoolSculpting work? Really, how does it work and does it work? CoolSculpting is the name brand for a technical procedure called cryolipolysis. And if you break that word down quite literally, it means cold to break apart or kill fat. And CoolSculpting is the safest and the most proven non-surgical way to target unwanted fat that lies above the muscle wall. So it's the name brand for a procedure. It is a medical procedure. So in order to find out if you're a candidate, you will have to attend a consultation. Consultations with us are entirely free. My name is Jessie. I am the founder and one of the CoolSculpting and CoolTone providers at Element Body Lab, the Dallas CoolSculpting experts. We are a CoolSculpting dedicated business. So all we do day in, day out is CoolSculpting. We freeze away unwanted fat. We're dedicated to the CoolSculpting portfolio. And we would love to talk to you about what your goals are. I do want to talk about the relationship between fat and cold and dive a little bit into how CoolSculpting works, a little bit of the science around it. So fat is hypersensitive to cold. And we know this because butter will change texture whenever you move it from the refrigerator to the counter and then back to the refrigerator, but you aren't freezing anything that's water composition. So we are able to get fat or lipid content to change texture at a much different rate than water content. And that is the principle of how CoolSculpting works. So what happens is we are actually using controlled cooling to selectively target and kill unwanted pockets of pinchable fat. So we're only able to target the fat that lies above the muscle wall. So if you think about this, anything that lies below the muscle wall, we can't get the area cold enough to target that fat without also causing damage to muscle, blood, nerves, other tissue. So the limitation of CoolSculpting is also the thing that keeps it safe. But let's talk about what happens in a CoolSculpting treatment. So what happens in a CoolSculpting treatment is we take stubborn pockets of pinchable fat. So if you imagine this little slide that you're seeing up here, number one. So anywhere that you've got stubborn pinchable pockets of fat, we call that subcutaneous fat, the fat that lies above the muscle wall. If you can imagine drawing that fat into a suction-based applicator, we'll talk about the applicators and the equipment that gets used. But what happens is that fat gets drawn into those applicators. It gets really, really cold. We use a heat extraction process to get the fat really cold. The fat cells change texture, much like putting butter into a refrigerator overnight. Sometimes people want to know, what's the temperature? Well, the temperature inside of the handpiece is negative 11 degrees Celsius. We hold at that temperature for 35 minutes with the most commonly used applicators. But treatment times range anywhere between 35 and 75 minutes. But essentially what we're doing there is we're changing the texture of the fat cells and triggering a natural programmed cell death. We call this apoptosis, natural programmed cell death. And so what that translates to is the change in texture triggers an inflammatory response in your body where your white blood cells, which are called macrophages, come along and digest those frozen fat cells, and then your body naturally processes them out using your lymphatic system. So you excrete them over the course of 3 weeks to 3 months. And everyone wants to know, well, where does the fat go? Well, it's excreted through your lymphatic system. And what that means is you can expect it to be excreted through urine, fecal matter, and sweat. So you're gonna pee, poop, and sweat it out over the course of 3 weeks to 3 months. Then comes the question, how much actually goes away? Well, what you can expect from a result standpoint is a 20 to 25% reduction of the tissue treated with each round of sculpting. So everyone has a different goal in mind. So sometimes people want more aggressive results, sometimes people want more conservative results, but what you can expect is an average reduction of between 20 and 25% on a bell curve with each round of treatment. So oftentimes people are doing a series of treatments or a series of sculpting in order to achieve more aggressive results. We have tons of before and after photos broken down so you can kind of see what that looks like, how many sessions, what does that mean? But I do want to talk about the different parts of the body that you can treat, because we can target anywhere between chin and knees. We talked a little bit about subcutaneous fat. Again, we treat the fat that lies above the muscle wall. And so what you can expect is anywhere that you've got pinchable fat that lies above the muscle wall, pending that it is fat and not something else, we can target it with CoolSculpting. So places like the chin, that's this little pocket right here, double chin, we could treat the axillary puff, that's that little pocket of fat right in the front of the armpit, back line, inner thighs, outer thighs, the main staple, abdomen, and love handles. People want to get rid of a muffin top all the time. Absolutely. As long as it is squeezable, it's freezable. That's the joke we make here around in the office. But what you can expect is we are able to customize a plan during a consultation. Our advice is usually, let's pick one place and get really good results in one area before we start moving to different places. Because it's intoxicating. You start to hear that you can freeze away unwanted fat and you're like, head, shoulders, knees, and toes. You want to treat everywhere. But really, with CoolSculpting, usually it takes a series of treatments, a minimum of two, in order to achieve an impactful result that you feel like is worth the investment. So we want you to invest in getting great results in one place before we start treating additional places. We'll talk a little bit about some of the areas that you can treat in different videos that you will see on our Instagram page, on our YouTube channel, and on our website, in case you want us to break down some of the different areas and see some before and after photos in those places. I would encourage you to check all of those places out. Again, Instagram, our website, and our YouTube channel. It's all elementbodylab.com, or elementbodylab is our handle on either of the social platforms. But during your consultation, we'll talk about these different places. We'll talk about your goals and your expectations, and then we're going to develop a customized plan based off of that. So I'm going to come back full screen here because I want to talk about the equipment that we use during a CoolSculpting treatment. This is called an applicator. So this here is an actual applicator that hooks up to my CoolSculpting machine, which is right back here. So this applicator plugs in, and then what happens is it uses suction to draw fat into these cooling cups. These are thermometer gauges. They're just temperature gauges to monitor the temperature out of the device. So what I want you to imagine is your fat being drawn into this little cooling cup. And what happens with that is it feels almost like a vacuum hose at a car wash gets a hold of your fat. So this is a medium size, but we have different sizes and shapes. So this is a larger handpiece. This is a medium, but we even have, I've got a template here to show you the smallest one. So this little one works great on a chin or that armpit fat, whereas this one may work on more common areas like love handles, upper arms, other places that are kind of medium sized. But fat draws into the cooling cup, and every time we put one of these on the body, there's a cost associated with it. So our goal is to make sure that we get full coverage and natural looking results. And so in a consultation, we're going to dive into your goals and your expectations to be able to discuss a cost, because these hand pieces have been designed with you in mind. They're designed to be able to curve along with the natural curves of the body and fit in specific places that have FDA clearances. So they're the safest and most proven option, but they're also really artistically designed and have developed so much over time. So my experience with CoolSculpting starts back in, you know, forever ago, back in the OG days of CoolSculpting, where the hand pieces actually were cooling plates on either side of the device. And so it almost looked like a vice grip. It used a tremendous amount of suction, felt like your soul was being sucked out of your body because of how much suction there was. Then the hand pieces evolved in 2017 or 18, and it was called the Cool Advantage portfolio. I do want to talk about the evolution between the Cool Advantage and the Elite, so I'm going to share this slide here. So the lower image is the Advantage technology. And the Advantage technology actually used a cooling cup, so you saw much more comfortable treatments and just better contact for patients. But the problem with that was it was really narrow, so you couldn't really get good contact with people who had a more athletic build, and it just wasn't very conducive to the natural curves of the body because of how narrow it was. And so they redesigned the hand pieces to be a little bit wider and to go from a just like a cup to like a C shape. And that evolution to the C shape really translated to something very important for you as a customer. So I'm going to change slides here really quick, because what you see now is the lower image again is that Advantage technology. It was more narrow, and what you're looking at is contact with the cooling panel. So both of these areas, they just covered the cooling cup, so the inside of the applicator with paint, and you can see how much more contact you're able to get with the Elite technology. So here at Element Body Lab, we vow to always offer the most up-to-date, the safest, and the most proven technology. And as of today, that is the elite technology with CoolSculpting. So what you will get here is elite technology with CoolSculpting, along with the highest trained providers. So I encourage you to schedule a consultation with a CoolSculpting provider near you. If you are in Dallas, Texas, or if you're willing to travel, which we have people travel from out of town all the time, we would love to have you here. My name is Jessie. I am the founder and I'm one of the CoolSculpting providers, but both myself and Jen, the alternate provider here, we both have extraordinary amounts of training. We're the highest trained. I serve as part of AMI faculty, which is actually the group of trainers for all CoolSculpting providers nationwide. So I'm a national trainer for Allergan Medical Institute, which is a huge honor to me. Jen has performed over 800 treatments herself alone. So you will get people who are CoolSculpting dedicated, who are kind, who are well-trained, and who have an artistic and scientific understanding of the CoolSculpting technology, because not all CoolSculpting is created equal. The technology has evolved, but also the skill of the provider evolves. So when you're considering who to let do your CoolSculpting treatment, whenever people say, how does CoolSculpting work and does it work? Yes, but just like all hairdressers use scissors and not all haircuts are good, lots of people offer CoolSculpting, but not all people have the same technology or skill. So I encourage you, schedule a consultation with our team. If you have any questions about CoolSculpting or CoolTone or anything in body contouring, we can cover that at a free consult. You do all online booking. You can schedule it using the link in our Instagram bio, on our website, elementbodylab.com, or if you're checking this out on YouTube, you'll see a link wherever it is that you're watching this video. I hope this was helpful. We hope to see you soon in office. And if not, then I hope you have the best and happiest journey with your CoolSculpting experience. Bye for now.